There are about 382 million people that live with diabetes, and 40 to 50% of the global population is labeled at high risk for pre-diabetes. That's about almost half the Earth's population who's at risk for pre-diabetes. And what's even more surprising, or maybe this won't come to you as a surprise, is that there's almost 2 billion people that are overweight. But what does that have to do with insulin resistance? Well, 70 to 80% of obese patients and virtually every patient with type 2 diabetes has some sort of insulin resistance. And this video will be going over 5 of the most common signs of insulin resistance that you can see on your skin that are super important to watch out for. By the end of this video, you'll get to see what these 5 signs are and hopefully give you some sort of clarity on insulin resistance as a whole, so you don't want to miss this. Stay tuned till the end. Hi guys, you've seen Arsalan, media pharmacist here on YouTube. If you guys want to learn more about making informed decisions about your health and wellness in an easy to understand way, then consider hitting that red subscribe button down below to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Also, a super easy way to support the channel is to take 2 seconds to gently tap that like button down below as well. And since you did like this video, I thought I'd show you a cute picture of a panda bear. Aww. Now, without further ado, let's get straight into it. Firstly, let's define our term, insulin resistance. What is it? And to put this super easy to understand and to make sure it clicks, insulin resistance is when cells in your muscles, fat, and liver don't respond well to insulin and can't use the sugar from your blood for energy. So when it can't use the sugar in your blood for energy, your pancreas makes more insulin, thinking that that would help. But since there's a resistance to insulin over time, your blood sugar levels go up and up and up, because the insulin can't do its job. Eventually, with more and more insulin, the insulin will be forced to tell the liver and muscles to start storing sugar. But too much sugar in your bloodstream is damaging to the vessels. But when they're full, the liver sends the excess sugar to fat cells to be stored as, you guessed it, body fat, which causes weight gain. And to fix this, you want to become the opposite, more insulin sensitive, which I'll be discussing this in another video. But how does this even affect the skin though? How does insulin affect what happens on the surface of my skin? That's an important question. Too much insulin or hyperinsulinemia activates what's called insulin growth factor 1 or IGF-1. And it targets the IGF-1 receptors located in fibroblasts and keratinocytes, both directly and indirectly. And when this happens, it stimulates their proliferation, causing them to undergo some type of change. And as you know, keratinocytes are the most prominent cell within the epidermis. About 90% of your skin is made up of keratinocytes, and IGF-1 affects them. So that is how you're seeing the connection of insulin resistance and its impact on the skin. And right now, the gold standard for insulin resistance diagnosis is called the euglycemic insulin clamp, which is a complex, invasive, costly, and pretty much unfeasible test to implement conveniently in clinical practice on an everyday basis. So skin manifestations of insulin resistance are a real-time way to get a straightforward and fast reading to what could potentially be going on with how the way your body responds to sugar and insulin on the inside. And we'll be looking at 5 signs of insulin resistance on the skin that you can check right now at home, starting with the first one, acrocordins. Acrocordins are those fibroepithelial polyps, or better yet known as skin tags. Now, I have a video on skin tags that you should check out too after this video if you want to learn more about them. Now, many people have skin tags that hang from a stalk. They're harmless and normal, but having numerous skin tags may be a sign that you have too much insulin in your blood, which is something to keep note of. As far as where you'll see them, most common places are on the eyelids, neck, armpit, and the groin. In fact, after you turn about 40, the frequency of getting skin tags is roughly 37% and are more common in women and overweight or obese individuals. However, there's also a familial genetic relationship as well. Usually treatment of this involves cryotherapy of the skin tag or excision under a doctor's care. Secondly, you have what's known as acanthosis nigricans, which is going to be a dark patch or a band of velvety skin, thick velvety skin to be exact, and that has that texture of a velvety touch to it, and that you find in the body folds and creases like the armpits, groin, and the back of the neck. It usually starts to develop slowly, and some find it to be itchy with an odor and develop skin tags around the area as well. And you often find this in patients with PCOS, as symptoms of PCOS could very well be insulin resistance as well, which in the meantime could be treated with lifestyle changes, topical retinoids, and lactic acid. The third is what's known as diabetic dermopathy, otherwise known as shin spots, since you'll most likely see them on the shins. In rare cases though, you'll see it on the arms, thighs, trunk, or other areas of the body as well. And most people mistaken them for age spots, but unlike age spots, these spots and lines usually start to fade after 18 to 24 months. Diabetic dermopathy can stay on the skin indefinitely, so keep that in mind. And if it produces dry, scaly patches, try applying a moisturizer to the area, as this is known to help. The fourth is what's known as necrobiosis lipotica. It's basically a skin condition that often begins as small, raised, solid bumps that look like pimples. But as it progresses, the bumps turn into patches of swollen and hard skin that could be yellow, reddish, or even brown. It's usually painful, and you can see the blood vessels and the surrounding skin around the area has that shiny porcelain-like appearance. And it goes through cycles where it's active, inactive, and then active again. So if you have noticed this phenomenon or any other ones that I've mentioned, it would be best to bring this up to your doctor to get this tested for diabetes if you have not yet been diagnosed. The fifth one is one that may be a little controversial because some argue that this isn't related back to insulin resistance, whereas some studies look at it as it being related to as an early sign, and that is androgenetic alopecia, which can happen to men and women. For women, the thinning is limited to the crown region, and notice that there is no affection of the frontal hairline. Keep in mind that insulin resistance isn't the only cause of this form of alopecia, which is why your doctor should test thyroid stimulating hormone, iron levels, and androgen levels so that they could use this to rule out other causes of alopecia, since there are many other causes out there. I know this isn't a full list of every single skin sign of insulin resistance, which is why I left a useful link down below from the American Academy of Dermatology Association. They'll provide more helpful information, so definitely check that out below. Diabetes can cause many other skin problems, and most skin problems are harmless, but even a minor one can become serious in people who have diabetes, which is why it's important to talk to your doctor so they can recognize skin problems due to diabetes and help you manage them. Click the red subscribe button down below and let me know what your thoughts are in the comment section. Seriously, your comments mean so much to me, and I love reading what you guys have to say. Like the video if you did enjoy it, and until then guys, I'll see you on the next one.